Russell Shaw.
I'm from Cary.
Where?
Cary.
North Carolina. I just lived in Cary last year. I moved to Chapel Hill this year. Do you? You like Josh? He's another head. I coached Josh when I was at Oklahoma State, so I know him. I'll chat with you guys a little bit and then show a little bit of technique. 45 minutes goes kind of fast. And this was a little bit last minute for me, but you guys all know much about UNC? Nothing? Well, Coleman Scott just got the head job about 3 years ago, going on our fourth season. I came with him. I'm his head assistant. I'm the big guy coach, recruiting coordinator, so we'll probably be talking to a lot of you. But we're a big up-and-coming program in the country. UNC used to suck. Now we're getting better. We had a pretty good NCAA tournament last year. We should have probably had four All-Americans. We had two All-Americans. Four guys in the round of 12, but definitely up and coming. What's anybody else? Is everybody else from Georgia? Where?
Memphis, Tennessee.
Tennessee, you know Phil Simpson? You know the Simpsons?
Yeah.
I lived with him out at the training center for a long time. Good family. Really got about 10 kids. Really?
Yeah.
When you go back, tell him Bryce Hossman did the compound thing. Everybody else from Georgia? We'll get in. I'm going to start slow. I think probably the best bet when you got college coaches from all over coming in is to show you basic technique. You know, we're all going to have different philosophies, different styles of wrestling. UNC is a very unique program because all the coaches really come from different backgrounds. I'll talk to you about that a little bit. Coleman Scott, who knows who Coleman Scott is? Olympic bronze medalist, national champion at Oklahoma State. He's more of an outside wrestler. Low singles, as you know, being from Oklahoma. Low singles, elbow ducks, stuff like that. Whereas Terry Brands was my coach for about 8-9 years when I was training for the Olympics with Coleman. And I'm more of a grinder. So I'm going to have not completely different philosophies, because winning at the highest level, it's really going to be the same. Every coach probably has the same basic principles. But I'm going to be more of I focus a lot more on defense, making sure you're not getting scored on. I think that's important. And obviously, you know, when you put your foot on the line and you're closing the gap with somebody, I'm going to get my hands on a guy as fast as possible, whereas someone like Coleman Scott, for instance, he's going to start jab picking and moving his feet. I can teach both, but, you know, a lot of my guys, even Chip Ness, Chip was an outside wrestler, and then I started working with him this year, and that's actually a great example. Chip Ness didn't know how to hand fight to save his life, and it's actually why he ended up All-American this year. He got seventh, probably the third best kid in the country, actually. And he's from right around here, right?
Yeah.
You coached him, Terry coached him. A lot of these guys had their hands on him, but Chip and Terry are really close. And Chip was a knucklehead for the longest time, but this year, and you guys can all relate, pay attention, you guys can all relate to a kid like that, because tons of talent, kind of lost his way when he went to college, wasn't on the same page as the coaches, coaching staff changed, and then he kind of got back on the same page and kind of found his way. But the reason he's a great example is because I kind of taught him how to hand fight. He would even put his hands on a guy, and got a lot stronger, and it really helped his wrestling altogether. His defense, he quit rolling around. You know, I'm not a big, I know there's a lot of people from this area that are roll around guys. I hate that shit. I'm not gonna lie to you. You know, I'm basic. But it helped Chip. anything in particular you guys want me to show, Terry?
Whatever you want to see, man.
Whatever you want.